For those of you who saw my video on how to build a cabin off the grid, I thought it'd be helpful to provide this video on how I built an outhouse to complement the cabin. As you might imagine, one of the first things we need to do is dig a few holes. These will be the corner posts for the outhouse. Each measures about 48 inches deep, which is just below the frost line to prevent any frost heaving in the winter. In the center where the pit's going to be, it also is about 4 feet deep. I reinforced this larger hole with pieces of treated plywood to actually form a box. With this outhouse being 4 feet by 8 feet, each corner post is a 4x4, which is set on top of a concrete cookie. These corner posts are then set into position and squared up as best possible. The 4x4s are then tied together using simple framing and GRK fasteners, which will provide adequate shear strength to keep the structure and support the weight. The framing is built such that the stool will be placed directly over the hole that we boxed out underneath. Next, the floor gets put into place, a hole cut for where the stool will go, and the walls start to go up, leaving room for the windows to be framed, as well as the front door. Now the rafters and the roof. Next, the doors and windows are set into place, as well as the house wrap. And here are a few shots on how the roof rafters and purlins were set into place. Next, I'll start to attach the steel underneath for my soffits. Next, I put the siding on the structure in board and batten style, the same as I did with my cabin. If you'd like information on how these are treated, please see my video on how to build an off-the-grid solar cabin for a little bit more instruction. As you can see, the construction of the outhouse complements the cabin quite well. It's only a few steps away, yet far enough away that you don't need to worry about odors. One thing you cannot see is the buried underground cable which connects the solar battery inside the cabin, which serves as a power source to the outhouse. Okay, let's talk about the inside. The inside is constructed with much of the same craftsmanship and materials as the cabin, with a wood floor and T111 siding. The toilet box is constructed of plywood construction with what's commonly known as diamond plate affixed to it. This is available in flexible form from one of the big box stores, and during the summer months it's quite refreshing to take a seat. In the winter, however, it will give your thighs a wake-up call. The electrical supply coming into the cabin supplies two different devices. It controls both the lighting and it also controls a 12-volt blower motor which is situated underneath the toilet box on the left-hand side. The blower motor feeds into the 4-inch PVC pipe which goes up through the stack. As you sit on the stool, it creates negative pressure between your legs and pulls air downward instead of upward as you sit and relax. The same lighting switch system is used in the outhouse as is used in the cabin. One last item worthy of mention is around the perimeter of the base of the outhouse where it intersects with the ground. I put in wire cloth to help prevent any animals from digging underneath the outhouse and into the space below the floor. I hope you found this to be a useful and enjoyable video. Enjoy the outdoors.